Hello, people. Welcome to this Wednesday. Today is Wednesday, April 27th, 4:27. May we have this 7:27 takeoff for a new landing on a new planet and a new planetary mind. Dedicate this to all the staff at Channel 18 Iowa City for their wonderful talents and gifts and abilities. And sometimes you got to praise and appreciate. So this is for Brian and Joshua, who's leaving, and Josh and James and everybody here, Dave. And so the wonderful talents that are available, that are just shining through this program here. So a big props and a big ups and a big thank you to everyone who's part of this Shine On show here. Green Fire is the green fire of your mind, but also the we're out howling with the wolves, so it's like the green fire in the wolf's eyes. Shining a light so that we can see that we gentle into a space where we understand that wolves have souls. Okay, isn't that something? We can understand that wolves have souls. Now, we're about ready to reach and appreciate that perception. And today is right before May Day, so this will be a May Day program. So everybody out there, if you haven't received a May basket, this is something you do, is you go out and get a basket and fill it full of something you like and drop it at the door of a friend's house or your wife and surprise them and leave and give them a May basket. That's a wonderful thing to do. And so May Day is an ancient Celtic ritual day. It's the halfway point between the vernal equinox and the summer solstice. It's literally the halfway point between spring and summer. So we're going to spring in this quantum leaping event, in this quantum leaping year of regeneration. We'll do something about what the ancients talked about in terms of Beltane, which is the name of May 1st from a Celtic perspective. Beltane is celebrated in different earth cultures throughout the planet. Do you know we're all on fire? Life is literally a fire burning in our bodies. Our biology magically takes in energy in tiny increments so we don't ignite. Still, it's a wonder more of us don't just spontaneously burst into flames. Beltane is a traditional time to renew, reawaken our life, reawaken our fire. Yeah, reawaken our fire, the inner fire, our hearth fire, community fire, sexual and fertility fire of people, animals, plants, the land. What about when there's way too much fire everywhere? In wars, in forests, in collapsed nuclear reactors, even freak fires in the Arctic. What about depression? Not enough creative fire. Soul fire, the moon fire, to bring balance and healing to offset the devastation. No way to get there from here. No way to get there from here. Well, today is our holy moment to quantum jump over the impossible and make love to the possible. If your head can't do it, let your heart try. Newborns of the body or imagination conceived on Beltane are merry begots, full of enough aliveness, love, joy, humor, to confound the toughest logic and the direst doomsday predictions. So the newborns of the body or imagination conceived on Beltane are merry begots, full of enough aliveness, love, joy, humor, to confound the toughest logic and direst doomsday predictions. Ah, Beltane, May 1st, Mary B. So this is a time when the waning half moon is in Aquarius on the 29th of April, just prior to May 1st. We're gonna stop here for a moment and dedicate this program to a person who has stood up for Mother Earth in many ways. Her name is Walking Mary from Bisbee, Arizona. And Walking Mary is one of the great lights of our time. She is now in in a resting in a hospital. And please send a little love and light and positive healing energy to Mary Adams, Walking Mary. She's from Illinois as a school teacher, but she's lived many years in Bisbee, Arizona, and she could use a little of your loving kindness sent her way with some positive healing energy for a woman who has overcome many battles of Babylon and patriarchy and living in the belly of the beast of a nuclear empire. And she has stood up for all the generations, for the seventh generation yet to come, to shut down all forms of nuclear on Mother Earth for a time when we have a nuclear-free planet. And Mary spent time in prison as a conscientious objector to the nuclear empire, having gone to Oak Ridge and been arrested at the Y-9 plant where they make nuclear bombs. And Mary is a person who is least understood. No one's ever heard of Mary Adams, but this is dedicated to all the Mary Adams out there, but to a real living saint who is named Walking Mary, Mary Adams. So this will be dedicated to Mary today. On May 1st, Mary be Mary Adams, and so may you be well in all ways, body, mind, psyche, spirit. In this sense, we are going to slowly shape shift here. And all you dudes out there in Iowa City and all you women, wherever you're at, may you walk and let this kind of soak in and seep into wherever you are, and may this kind of be a little blessing and say, hey, you'll do, and you're beautiful as you are, just as you are. And that's what this is. You're a beautiful star already, just being reborn and birthed. And don't forget, we all come from the stars. We are made of stardust. Now imagine where you're from. Maybe you have a whole galactic civilization out there connecting up with you by starlight at night. And so when we want to look into the deepest part of ourselves and the freest part of ourselves, we look up into the night sky. The night sky can be our deliverer from all kinds of stuff. So what we'll do here is move into a piece that was written a couple days ago, actually yesterday, and it covers the understanding of things that have a resonance field that moves beyond the time-space continuum that we are in. This is called upgreening. So like when you're born and you have, you know, you grow up, and like we all have our favorite places where we learn how to ride our bike and our friends and our hiding places growing up here, and those are the most enjoyable reflections. So this is called upbringing, but in this upstart spring where the greening is in the trees all around us and the flowering blossoms of the blossoming trees and just the hint of the early lilac of May, you'll see them out here, the lilac bushes. So kind of breathe that in and get the freshness of the lilac fragrance. And come around the village campfire here and celebrate what is upgreening. Upgreening. Oh, upgreening. It's spring. The inside is making itself like the outside. Upgreening. We are greening up. We are new upbringing. Birds appear, and the birds appear in the early morning song of rolling away the dew. Birds appear in the early morning song, rolling away the dew. We are greening up, dear friend. We are greening up. And then buds appear. Buds appear. And they grow from the inside out into more and more complexity. The acorn turns into oak. We grow out, dear friend. That is evolution. Birds appear, And we grow out, dear friend. We grow out from a little bud, and we grow out and out into more and more complexity. We grow from the inside out. That is evolution. Birds appear, and then there is an unfurling of leaves which whirl out in slow phase. There is an unfurling of leaves, dear friend, from these little buds of the growing edge of spring, and they whirl out in slow phase. They whirl out in slow phase, gradually breathing in this upstart spring. This resonance is awakening of consciousness, of upgreening. This resonance is awakening of consciousness, of upgreening. Windows are open. Windows are open. Little by little by little, windows are open. And slowly, wide open. Breathing in and breathing out. Breathing in love, breathing out peace. Breathing in love, breathing out peace. Breathing in love, breathing out peace. Breathing in and breathing out. Birthing in love and birthing out peace. Birthing in love and birthing out peace. Birthing in love and birthing out peace. Biodiversity is the spice of life, sprucing up. Biodiversity is the spice of life, sprucing up. We are greening up, dear friend. We are greening up. Breathe in the fragrance of all this upstart alchemy. Breathe in the fragrance of all this upstart alchemy. Breathe in this swim. This whole planetary growing anew. This whole planetary birthing and growing anew. Upgreening is within. Upgreening is within. Breathing in love, breathing out peace. Birthing in love, birthing out peace. Upgreening is birthing within. Ah! Beginner's mind, upgreening. In this upstart spring, the first goes into our mind, and then we collapse our mind into our heart. So we walk the soft path. So we walk with our heart and our mind in our heart, which is metanoia. Mind within itself is mind within a heart. It's a heart mind. And the second, we'll do the collapsing of the mind into our heart, which is surrender to a higher purpose. Upgreening. It's spring, dear friend. The inside is making itself like the outside. Upgreening. The inside is making itself like the outside. Upgreening. We are greening up. We are new upbringing. Buds appear. The buds appear on the growing edge of the little twigs of the trees. Buds appear in March and in April. And then slowly, 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 they grow from the inside out in wonder into more and more complexity. The acorn turns into the oak. We grow out, dear friend. We grow out. That is evolution. Birds appear. Unfurling of leaves. Now with the buds, there is the growing and the birthing and the unfurling of leaves. Unfurling of leaves which whirl out in slow phase. There is an unfurling of leaves which whirl out in slow phase. Gradually, gradually, gradually. Breathing in this upstart spring. Breathing in this upstart spring. Birthing in all around this upgreening in this upstart spring. This resonance is the awakening of consciousness, of upgreening. This resonance is the awakening of consciousness, of upgreening. Windows are open slowly now. Windows are open slowly, slowly, slowly. Now, slowly, wide open. Breathing in and breathing out. Biodiversity is the spice of life sprucing up. Biodiversity is the spice in all these fragrances on the flowering lilacs and the flowering trees. Biodiversity is the spice of life in this fragrance of the immensity of this journey sprucing up. We are greening up, dear friend. We are greening up. We breathe in the fragrance of the lilacs. Breathe in the fragrance of these flowering trees. Breathe in the fragrance of all this upstart alchemy. Breathe in the fragrance of all this upstart alchemy. Birth ourselves in the fragrance of all this upstart alchemy. Breathe in this swim, the whole planetary growing anew. The whole planetary greening anew. The whole planetary growing anew. Upgreening is within, dear friend. Ah, beginner's mind. This is a perception for our proprioceptors in our neocortex. Sharpening our axons and getting a close, soft focus of the gentling, greening of this upstart alchemy of spring. And literally, this is a regeneration in quantum leaping from the synapses and on their axons and the dendrites for a new global brain. This time, we're slowing things down. So if we want to have conservation, preservation, and restoration, which is a CPR for the global planetary CPR. Planetary CPR, conservation, preservation, restoration. And if we want to do this for climate change, what we do is we plant trees, reforestation, increase the biodiversity of the biota on Biami of water planet, blessed Mother Earth, Aquaterra. This is exchange of spirit of language birds here. These are twinned opposites who are reconciled, polar opposites which are reconciled to the harmonia mundi, the harmony of Mother Earth, the anima mundi, the soul of Mother Earth, and the axia mundi, the axis of Mother Earth in a biodiversity field of wonder. And this is all phases are at play here. And in restoration, for a balance of restoration of the global weather change, climate change, we want to simply plant a tree or something that's similar to that to amplify biodiversity and hold the center. Hold the center. This is the axis of May 1st. It's like the fixed is a cardinal point, which is opposite. It's opposite the other points, which are north, south, east, and west. The direction of May 1st on the cycle of things, if you go like that, May 1st, now your left, my left hand is your right hand, so just put it the opposite there. That points up to the north and the west. So May 1st is the northwest. So heading in the northwest, Pacific Northwest, planetary northwest, the Northwest Passage, Alaska, that's the that's Turtle Island North, okay? Northwest, north, northwest. So that up there is pointing toward the head of the turtle, of Turtle Island. The head of Turtle Island is Alaska. Rocky Mountains are the backbone of Turtle Island, and its tail is Central America. So we're heading up the backbone up in the Pacific Northwest on Beltane, May 1st, pointing toward Northwest there, and toward Oregon, Vancouver, British Columbia, Banff, Washington, Yukon, Alaska, Northwest Territories. So this is all this wildness of nature, and nature is the preservation of the world. In nature is the preservation of the world. So let's sometimes just step outside the city and go out into nature, but sometimes you step right into nature inside the city. But underneath this is the world tree, the planetary tree. The axis mundi is no less than the tree, the planetary world tree, the planet mind tree. And in this asymmetrical in nature, and we could call this the tree of unknowing. This is the tree of life, and it's pointing in toward the asymmetrical spiral of the Northwest Passage, which is literally a spirit-mind metaphor, which led all these people out of Europe looking for the Northwest Passage. Well, this is a mystery school, great mystery school, which is Mother Earth itself. And Chewana Gorge is the Columbia River Gorge. So we're going to get rid of that dam up there in the Columbia River. So in that sense, let's look for something that can help do that. Is there a under the sign of the water bearer? Well, that's possible, under the sign of the water bearer. And this is the freeing of the Columbia River Song, Chewana. So Chewana is the name of Columbia, and this is pointing toward the Northwest Passage. This is to restore the Celilo Falls and the sleeping woman of Celilo, who's 11,000 years old. The crack of waters converging. The crack of waters converging as east meets west. Cracks out. The thudding water shouts a crushing, sudden force of earth, louder than a shot heard round the world. This is elder force, dear friend. This is elder force, dear friend. This is the sleeping woman at Celilo Falls, 11,000 years old and 11,000 years deep into the fjords of the Ice Age, the Glacial Age. Louder than a shot heard round the world. This is elder force, dear friend. Water, surge, converge. As if the fabric of the sky were torn asunder, the crack of waters converging, the cement walls crumple, and the water wells forth. Fish ladders become toothpicks, cookie houses. Under a 60-foot force flood, who needs fish ladders when salmon have free water flowing? The cement walls crumble, and the water wells forth. Fish ladders become toothpicks, cookie houses under a 60-foot flood. Who needs fish ladders when salmon have free water flowing? The crack of waters converging, then a glowing, strange, hypnotic, orange, purple, pink cloud. Then a glowing, strange, hypnotic, orange, purple, pink cloud surges forth, and a 1,000-foot-long apparition, wiggling, wriggling, jumping, arching, floats up from the ocean. Grandmother Salmon surges back from the Pacific over the liberated waters. The false facade of techno-imperial energy ripped in an instant into shreds in the older fabric, instantaneously underneath, returning. What is energy? How do we feel it? It's not about these trinkets that we plug in. What do you think it means when we say, you cannot dam the river, you cannot dam the river? She will rise, baby, she will rise. You cannot dam the river. The freeing of Chewana, Columbia River, and the restoration of Celilo Falls and the sleeping woman at Celilo Falls, the sleeping woman of Celilo Falls who looks into both worlds, of the techno-imperial candy factory that only lasts an instant in time, and these trinkets fall like glitter's gold, fool's gold that has no value. The false facade of techno-imperial energy ripped in an instant into shreds and the older fabric instantaneously underneath returning. What is energy? How do we feel it? It's not about these trinkets that we plug in. What do you think it means when we say, you cannot dam the river? You cannot dam the river, dear friend. She will rise, dear friend. She will rise. Hail Chewana. Hail Chewana. Hail Celilo Falls. Hail sleeping woman at Celilo Falls. Rising, rising, rising. So that's in the global planetary mind, the restoration of global brain. We talked about proprioceptors and planting trees will help the dendrites. So there's a human tree relationship. The lungs of Mother Earth, if you look at the tree, it looks like the lungs of Mother Earth. And the tree gives off oxygen. And as we breathe, we give off carbon. So we give the tree the breath that it needs, and the tree gives us the breath that we need. It's a biofeedback loop, an infinity of biofeedback loop, breathing in and breathing out. It's a beautiful thing, these trees. And these trees have standing, and it's always important when we plant a tree for reforestation that we have reverence for trees, because they help the global brain and the global mind. It helps develop our minds, literally. And we sharpen our axons when we do so. So this is part of the affirmation of May 1st as taking a deep ecology look into our very own being. And so we have done upgreening as part of the awakening of spring. And what we're going to do is a piece that brings into focus both our concern for peace and justice and cultural diversity, and the least of these, taking care of our brother who may be homeless, and biodiversity, which is the plants, flora, fauna, and so biodiversity and cultural diversity, so we can be upright human beings with standing upright and vertebrate and speaking our truth. This is called Stalking the Wild Rainbow. Jumpstart your kaleidoscope heart, dear friend. Jumpstart your kaleidoscope heart. No one on this mountain is real. No one on this mountain is real. I'm going where the angels cannot go. I'm going where the angels cannot go. Going down lonely road, dear friend, to retrieve a friend. Soul tossed and lost in the back of Kickapoo County in the caboose with a papoose over on his head. And that's way out in the Palouse somewhere in the Inland Empire. He's one of the fallout boys from the radioactive economy which went down, down, down. And from the radioactive economy with a prison searchlight, Rentgen rays flattening him down in some homeless shelter in the bushes on the night shadow edge of some unknown city park. Out on the edge, wedged away, out on the edge of the backlots of some lost, lonely, unknown little Colorado town. I've come to retrieve this wretched of the railroad earth. I've come to retrieve this wretched of the railroad earth, this itinerant waif, and dip him into the double dream of spring, dear friend, This double helix is Janus faced. For the new beginning, right here, right now. Don't forget, May 1st is Workers' Day, too. Haymarket Square. This double helix is Janus faced, dear friend. For the new beginning, right here, right now. This Bethlehem event lay in the hay in a manger. This Bethlehem event lay away in the hay in a manger. For the May Day, Earth First, Mirth Birth. Yes, Beltane fertility dancing maidens around the maypole in orgy ecdysiasmos. In orgiastic ecdysiasmos. With the Amanita Hobi mushrooms glowing. With Amanita Hobi mushrooms glowing. And glowing, stalking the wild rainbow. Jumpstart your kaleidoscope heart, dear friend. Jumpstart your kaleidoscope heart. We're collapsing our mind down into our heart through the sacred act of surrender to something better, your friend, your lover, the higher purpose, care for one another, for the least of these. Jumpstart your kaleidoscope heart, dear friend. No one on this mountain is real. I'm going where the angels cannot go. I'm going down lonely road to retrieve a friend. Soul tossed and lost in the back of Kickapoo County, in the caboose with a papoose on his head from Kalapuya, clear up in the Palouse, just off of Chewana in the Inland Empire of Babylon. He's one of the fallout boys, dear friend. He's one of the fallout boys from the radioactive economy with no safety net, with a prison searchlight Rentgen rays flattening him down in some homeless shelter in the bushes on the night shadow edge of some unknown city park. Out on the edge, wedged away, out on the edge, wedged away of the back lots of some lost, lonely, unknown little Colorado town, heading down US 50, heading east on US 50 to Dodge City. Did he ever make it? That's for you and me, dear friend, in the great mystery. That's for you and me in the great mystery, dear friend. I've come to retrieve this wretched of railroad earth and dip him into the double dream of spring. This double helix is Janus faced for the new beginning right here, right now. This Bethlehem event lay away in the hay in a manger. This Bethlehem event lay in the hay away in the manger for May Day, just waiting for May Day. Earth first, mirth birth. This Beltane fertility rites of the dancing maidens dancing around the maypole in orgy ecdysiasmos. Turning, spinning the 144,000 rainbow dreamer wheels alive. Spinning the rainbow dreamer wheels alive. Spinning the 144,000 rainbow dreamer wheels alive. This Beltane fertility dancing maiden dancing around the maypole with Amanita Hobi mushrooms glowing. With Amanita muscaria Hobi mushrooms glowing, dear friend. Stalking the wild rainbow. I'm not waiting for a lady, I'm waiting for a friend. I'm not waiting for a lady, I'm waiting for a friend. This is a deeper understanding of the tender earth. So like, love for one another That's when everything becomes anew. As we extend out a new scripture for humanity, love for one another. Love one another so you can love yourself. That's the first and only that's the first and only witness that really needs loving kindness. Love for one another is for the least of these. If we're not loving the least of these, who are we? If we use our imagination and we look into other continents, Darfur, India, the wretched of the earth, the homeless, the refugee, and if we don't see that human being through our imagination, the truly great gift we have is that is another myself. In Lakesh, Allah Khan, I am another yourself. You are another myself. That's the Gans Andere, the holy other. The holy other is with the WHOLLY, the holy other, with that concern for the least of these, for the homeless, the down and out, those in prison, those in the hospitals, those are without shelter, for the concern for the least of these, that holy other becomes the holy other. And through imagination, in Lakesh Allah Khan, I am another yourself, you are another myself. Namaste means simply, when the divine in you sees the divine in me, and the divine in me sees the divine in you, we are one, dear friend. We are divinized. We are the holy other. We are the gift to one another. And with this gift to one another, we rise. And in this rising, uprising spring, this is the gift of the heart, breathing in. Ah, breathing in love, breathing out peace. Breathing in love, breathing out peace. Breathing in love, breathing out peace. This is the gift of the rainbow that's coming. There's power in that rainbow, much power in the rainbow, much power. So this is for all the people out there. And in that sense, we rise to a higher understanding of awareness and consciousness of our own path. And dear friend, it is good to ask yourself from time to time and over again, what is your mission on earth? What is your mission on earth? You gotta ask yourself that almost every day. You have a mission on earth, you have a mission. And what is your mission on earth? And obviously it transcends just not getting ahead. So like, what is your mission on earth? And ask yourself, does this path have a heart? And what is the impact of this path on the seventh generation yet to come? And honoring the wisdom of our ancestors. So we have arrived at a place in Western tradition where we make things, but making things means nothing because it's really not organic. In the East, in the Oriental, they talk about the child talks to his parents about growing things. And in the West, the kid talks about making things. Well, the growing things is organic, okay? That's natural, organic. You look at the little bud that complexifies and spirals out, grows from the inside out, becomes a leaf, or the acorn becomes an oak. So we look at monotheism. It's a transplant plant religion from a Semitic culture in the Middle East. Dead Sea, the Red Sea, the Dead Sea and the desert there, and the Red Sea. That's where the monotheism of the Abrahamic religions comes from. Abrahamic, you know, is like Judaism, Christianity, and Muslim. And that monotheism is a patriarchy. And that is actually a desert religion that's a transplant into a forested culture, which is the Northern European culture, which is forested. So that's a desert religion imposed on a forested culture. So you think about that. It's imposed, it's forced upon a forested culture. And you see, when that happens, we begin to clear cut and kill the forest. You see that happening right here in River City. You see what they're doing all around here. They're just clear cutting all the old cultural heirloom places, just bulldozing them, right? And then they're putting up these vertical Galapagos islands of concrete, which is the closing down of the Iowa City mind, the closing down of literacy, the closing down of the Iowa City mind, blind to any cultural artifacts underneath that concrete. And that Iowa City is going to pay. That's soul destroying the city. And as a friend told me last week, it's just evil, evil empire rising with each concrete brick going vertical. That's evil, evil rising. It's the soul destruction of Iowa City. Plus any other city, you look, other cities just become the same. This is like a monotheism. That's a monoculture of concrete. So when monotheism came to Europe and forced and started killing the forest culture and forced itself on, it was around 600 AD, the fall of the Roman Empire. And then that became the Holy Roman Empire, which is a monotheism, monotheistic religion. There's only one God, replacing all these tree gods and Teutonic gods and Wovoka gods, the invoking nature, spirit, druidic, Wiccan gods, Nordic gods, and goddesses, which were both. They were both goddess. These were goddess cultures. So this in comes monotheism. It's called the blade. It's the blade culture. It's a predator culture with the cross and the blade. The cross becomes a blade, and that cuts everything horizontally and then goes vertically with the cross, and it becomes a grid of longitude and latitude, and sets a grid in hectares upon the planet, where land, which has never before become property, actually becomes property and monetized, and land as goes up for sale. You steal the land from the indigenous cultures, and then you turn it into property, which turns it into capitalism, profits, and money, and real estate, landowners, developers, concrete, concretization, killing of a civilization. And that's barbarian nature, barbarian nation. It's better known as the Kurgan wave. Well, there's another thing called the Kondratiev wave, which has not so good news for the Kurgan wave culture. We'll talk about that next time. But monotheism comes in, right? The one God, right? And then you have that patriarchy, which leads to capitalism, which leads to colonization, which leads to creative destruction, which is part of capitalism. You have to destroy things to make things new. It's constantly destroying. Just look out here in Iowa City. It's a pure charnel house, a hellhole of this fucking creative destruction, insanity, mania of capitalism. Capitalism belongs in some insane asylum. Let's just pull together everybody part of capitalism and just send them to the fucking nut house. It's an insane asylum on the land. The asylum has the inmates of the asylum are running the banks. Okay. The inmates of the asylum, the psychopaths, are running the construction companies. The inmates of the asylum are running the bulldozer, the real estate developers. All these are inmates of the asylum, of capitalism, which is insane mind. Okay, so that's a portion of capitalism is creative destruction. Make everything obsolete in 5 years, destroy it, make more money. Make more money. Make more money. It's a mantra. Make more money. Bottom line. Maximize profits. Okay, so that's insanity. And the planet cannot stand much longer this insanity. This is leading to global warming. Capitalism leads directly to global warming. You see the implications? Start filling in the blanks, dear friend. When you kill a forest, what do? You come in and you put in a oil, you know, start mining for gold, coal, drilling for oil. That's got a half-life of two generations, but the devastation is for hundreds, if not thousands, of years. and it destroys people's cultural artifacts, people's culture, Native Americans, indigenous peoples. So that's really intentional to create and to destroy everything and control it. That's a form of capitalism, okay? So that's a vertical axis like this, and that's in the sea that the Native Americans saw this coming. They saw the cross with that horizontal was well over halfway up. They said that's a man out of balance with that horizontal axis is not in the center, it's up here. That cross, right, the cross of the crucifixion of earth peoples, right? So that came into Europe and then that then came to America in 1492 and if not before and started the plunder and the colonization of the Americas and then Africa and then all the rest of the world through monotheism. And so that was not a Mediterranean religion. The Mediterranean means middle of the earth, and that was a forest. That was a forest religion, and then that was the desert religion was forced onto a forest religion. And guess what? And when that desert religion is forced on a forest religion, they clear cut the forest, and they give the long hairs and all the native and indigenous peoples. They give them a buzz cut. They give them a haircut. They use a lawnmower and just mow their mind. They mow their forest. They kill everything that is biodiversity and complex, which is growing things. So that becomes a made culture. You make this, you make that. But in a growing culture, it unfolds slowly from the inside out. It's not imposed from up, from above and outside in. These are very important notices here. One, you can breathe, the other asphyxiates and sucks out the air, sucks the air out of the room, sucks the air out of the ecosystem, sucks the air out of the airshed and the biosphere. That's where we get global warming. Okay, so this is this becomes a patriarchy where the state is the religion of the state, of the monetized mind, capitalism, where the banksters run the legislature, and the legislature is, nature is no longer part of the legislature. And we lose the voices of the circle into biodiversity and the council of all beings, and we only have a anthropocentric and anthropocentric Congress, a legislature, only humans. And the non-humans have no voice and no say. So we need to restore the circle and the legislature of nature and the biodiversity to be a spokesperson in the council of all beings so that the biodiversity can be restored in a planetary CPR, conservation, preservation, restoration, planning through reforestation. Each person plant one, each person reach one, each person teach one. These very subtle but important things. So the archy, which is a patriarchy, could be a matriarchy, but literally it's a state religion. And the anarchy of nature is decentralized. Anarchy, that means against the state or out from the state, away from the state. Could be against the state or it could be apart from the state. The state doesn't have imprimatur, the state doesn't have centralized control. That is anarchy, and then archy, state. It's away from the state. So this is a term that we need to look at the natural roots of, because the natural roots in nature are anarchic, which is biodiversity and diversity, the complexity through diversity, not through monotheism, which is one, or through that moves right into monocultures, corn and soybeans, destroying all the other agricultures and silvicultures there are. Yeah, we could be having hemp. Can you think about that? Think of the applications of hemp in our culture for sustainable soil, for rich soil, to leach the black earth out of chemicals and poisons and toxics. Let's plant hemp, man, hemp everywhere. We can have hemp paper, we can have hemp newspapers. It's just hemp forever. And it can have hemp clothing, And the hemp economy is local in its biodiversity, and its land, air, and water in balance, in the eco, in the watershed, in the ecosystem, and in the airshed. And it's called bioregional, this whole systems thinking. This is thinking, thinking like a mountain. This is getting out of our concretized mind. So this has come to our attention because one of the status, we're talking static here, not status. One of the static centers of the entire country is Iowa City, Iowa right now. One of the static centers in the entire country because of the concretized mind just obliterating all culture and heirloom culture and landmark culture throughout the different neighborhoods and villages of the city. So it used to call itself, and you're looking at static, stratified, concretized mind. People walking around in concrete statues in their minds. And this used to be seen as an heirloom, one of the three heirloom cities on planet Earth for literature. Iowa City, Vienna, and Beijing, I think, were the three cities given UNESCO status as the three centers of literacy on planet Earth. And guess what they've done? Instead of going in that direction and honoring the culture, they've just decided, fuck that shit. We're knocking all that cultural artifacts and beautiful oasis, Athens of the Midwest. We're just gonna take a bulldozer. We're gonna knock it down, and we're gonna put up concrete, go vertical. We're gonna close our minds. So this is the cloning and the closing of the Iowa City mind. As I said, it's a static center of the entire cosmos. But when it becomes a static center of the entire cosmos because of its literary identification, it's closing of that window to the universe. The Sipapu, yeah, it's the closing of that. So it's the closing of the closing of the planetary mind. The cloning and the closing of the Iowa City mind has huge repercussions. And it ripples out across the entire desert landscape, which used to be the ocean. Now it's dried up. It's just nothing but a desert of concrete out here. If you want to see what maybe you look at from a planet in the future, how the Earth did itself in, and they come and the our archaeologists of the future would have a heyday in Iowa City, Iowa, how they took an entire culture that was beautiful and very precious and just concretized it and killed themselves because they got comfortably numb with their wealth, where money forced culture and the goddess of graces of literature and art and music to genuflect and become a slave and literally become bound and tied and gagged, muzzled corporate carnivores, the banksters, Attila the banks, the bankroller, Attila the stockbroker. It's all here. You can all come and see it, folks. It's the Disneyland of the Attila the stockbroker. You want to see a wonderland of these people just getting their yayas and salivating at the mouth over all their man-made accomplishments, which amounts to a pillar of pulverized dust. And you don't look back when Gomorrah hits. So this is the Galapagos concretized islands of concrete skyscrapers and bulldozer and parking ramps here in good old River City. It's become Galapagos, and it's already frozen in time, and it frozen because it froze itself in mind. Frozen in mind and time, so it's a clone of itself. Okay, so out of that, we have a tremendous understanding of the concretized culture. And I believe we want to rise up out of that and say enough concrete for this generation, enough for the seventh generation. And so like, hey, people out here in Iowa City, like for the new graduate school, the work-study programs and practicum, the going to become a requirement that all grad students do 2 years of service to their county, their country, and their community by grabbing a jackhammer and jackhammering all this concrete down into rubbles and restore some sanity in this town. But you can't become a grad student until you do 2 years of hard jackhammer work knocking all this concrete down. And that's the agreement. No degree unless you grab a jackhammer and knock this Babylon down. Hey, you people out there who believe in restoring the earth, whether you call yourself earth firsters or others, there's no compromise in defense of Mother Earth. That's the fierce amor e rabia, love and rage in the green fire of the wolf's eyes. And as we said, once we understand that wolves have souls, we begin to restore ourselves of some sanity and understand that in nature is the preservation of the world. And in that sense, we are reified to the holy other. And just a little bit of gratitude song. We'll just finish this up with something of a lighter note. On this earth planet time that we're in, and this is something for the planet. And that is a celebration of life on this planet Earth. And we'll just go right to it here. Enoch cried, this is song in the key of Earth. Enoch cried, flames in his Dybbuk fingers, etching stone in the living word, flames of fire and blood in the living re of these times, connecting fire to mind, pyramid, fire in the middle of the mind, where the mind drops down into the heart. We surrender into something, dear friend, deeper than ourself. This brings us into the serenity of eternity, where the heart has wings, where the dove does sing. Our heart song, dear friend, with glimmerings round the sun, shining our rainbow self, through radiance, as crystalline prism sun dogs on an ice castle day, fire and ice, dear friend, breathed as pneuma, steam breaths. And in this upstart spring of alchemy spring, where there is transpiration, evaporation, transpiration into condensation, and the sacred holy breath of the earth breathes into the clouds, which breathes its beautiful rainbow seeding, grandmother, grandfather clouds making rainbow love and seeding the earth with the new light rain of spring back into the black, fertile earth of Iowa. And this, once we're part of this cycle, and we see the cycle, evaporation, transpiration, condensation, back around, up through the clouds, back to earth, feeding the trees, back up, transpiration, the breath of earth into the clouds, breathing the clouds of the breath of the sky back into the earth as this cycle. Once we see this cycle, then we become part of the cycle, and we are the cycle. We surrender into something deeper than ourself. This brings us into the serenity of eternity, where the heart has wings, where the dove does sing our heart song with glimmerings round the sun, shining our rainbow self through radiance as the crystalline prism sun dogs on an ice castle day, fire and ice breathed as pneuma steam breath, fire etched in living words of the lion of courage, flames of breath singing upward, laughter of mirth on earth, living, 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 dear friend, songs in the key of earth. Happy May Day, dear friend. May this restoration of the birth of mirth on earth through through a deeper understanding of what we're dealing with and where we're going, be a flowering in your heart and your loved ones, and a heart sutra that surrounds in a leaping, quantum leaping, and a growing spiral dance around the cycle, so that we now begin to become again, once again, on the commons, part of the cycle. Aho. Peace.
Peace.